Mikey Boggs, the race leader in a 4B. Dustin Limble, second. Dennis Earp, junior, third. Greg Johnson, fourth. Again, the top four transfer on to the Friday Night Rumble presented by Neat Service Center. As we're one lap shy of the midpoint now. Boggs showing away in the 4B. They'll come to the halfway show in heat one. I need heats two and three in staging, please. Heats two and three in staging. Tommy Carlton slows at the bottom of the racing surface. And it looks like he's going to pull in the infield. His heat's done. He'll be the main bound. We've got six in the books. Field working lap number seven. And it is all Jackie Boggs out in front. Seven up, laps up on the Pepsi scoreboard, three to go. And race leader Boggs making encounter some slower traffic before this was done. He's closing in on the 16 of Jake Henry as the two to go signals out, two to go in this one. White flag about to be displayed from chief starter Jody Rerun Coons. One to go here in this one. Jackie Boggs holds on one more lap. He will be the pole sitter for the Friday Night Rumble. Into turn three, off of turn four, Grayson's Kentucky's Jackie Boggs, the winner of Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat 1. Dustin Limble comes home in second. Dennis Earp Jr. third. Greg Johnson will roll home in fourth with Derek Fisher fifth. Top four transfer on, finishing in a fourth to 15 of Greg Johnson, third to 28 of Dennis Earp Jr., second to D8 of Dustin Linville, and grabbing the win in Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat Race number one. He's 44 years of age in his own Swartz race car with a J. Dickens engine, sponsored by Quick Response, Renegade Fuels, and CMW Racing. Out of Grayson, Kentucky, big round of applause for Jackie Boggs. Super late model heat two to staging, please. Need and McGuire set to try it again. They want them in the chalk box here off turn four. Eyes on them. Green's out, and here we go. And McGuire jumps to the lead, Need out of shape. He, Ratliff, and Combs three wide down the back, shooting into turn number three. Combs to the outside. He's going to grab the runner-up slot while Ratliff works beneath Need for third down into turn number one. Top four transfer. Going away. If he wins it, it will make for an all-Grayson Kentucky front row in the night's A main. Neat beneath Combs off two. He'll grab the runner-up slot. Neat looking for the lead off two. Not able to get it done as we're going to be one lap shy of the midpoint right here. McGuire and Neat doing it out side by side off four for the lead. Going to be coming to the halfway signal right here. McGuire and Neat battling for the race lead. Five down, five to go in Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat Race number two. There'll be six laps scored this time. McGuire and Neat go to settle the issue amongst themselves. Combs is third, Ratliff fourth. Then it's Arms, Roberson, Rawlings, and Meredith. McGuire and Neat still 1-2. They're about to see the two to go signal. Two to go in Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat Race number two. Neat dive bomb to the bottom, but not able to make the move, and he lost some ground coming off turn two as we're about to see the white flag for Josh McGuire. One to go in heat two. McGuire heads him down the back straightaway off of turn four for the final time. Grayson, Kentucky's Josh McGuire, the winner of Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat 2. Brad Neat goes second. Chris Combs will take third. Justin Ratliff will finish fourth. with Ricky Arms completing the top five. On to the Friday Night Rumble presented by Nate Service Center. Fourth, the 16 of Justin Ratliff. Third, the 47 of Chris Combs. Second, the 11 of Brad Neat. And grabbing the win in Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat 2. In the Creative Kitchen, sponsored number 41 JMR race car out of Grayson, Kentucky. Big round of applause for Josh McGuire, former two-time Richmond Raceway Butterball Woolridge Memorial winner. Need and Francis will try to get here in Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat 3. Green's out, here we go. Need and Francis fireman to turn one. Francis jumps to the race lead. Dustin Need second. Mike Marler's going to be third. John Gill fourth after lap number one. Clarence Belcher fifth. Jerry Rutherford sixth. Timmy Taylor seventh. And problems on Neat's machine. He slows up to the top side of turn number one, and that's going to draw the caution flag. Race run on this Friday night 1 year ago. 50-50 tickets on sale, $1 a piece, six for $5. They will be, sales will end after the Super Late Model B mains. Francis set to bring them back to green at the cone. Green's back out, here we go. Marler looking at eight. Francis for the lead. Off two down back the back straightaway. They'll go side by side into turn three. Francis and Marler still side by side. Francis by a half car length at the line. That time by with two in the books. They're still side by side. Francis will nose out in front off the top side of two. Marler falls back in behind him in second. John Gill is third. Clarence Belcher fourth. But here comes the six of Dustin Need looking to get the fourth spot. He's got that done on four down the front chute. And Neat looking for more as he closes in on the 49 of John Gill down into turn number three. As Francis and Marler going to settle this amongst themselves as we start to close in on the halfway point of this one. Neat to the inside of Gill off of two down the back chute. They're still side by side for the third spot. Dustin Neat will clear Gill now off four for the third spot as we're five in, five to go in Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat 3. And the five of Timmy Taylor will pull his machine to the infield. He is qualifying. He finished. Seven laps to go up this time. Steve Francis continues to show the way in the 25 as Mike Marler holds down the runner-up spot. Dustin Neat rides in third. John Gill fourth. Jerry Rutherford fifth. And Clarence Belcher is sixth as we've got two to go in heat number three. White flag is out, less than a lap to go now off of turn number four, Ashland, Kentucky. Steve Francis, the winner of Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat Race number three. The 5B of Mike Marler will come home in second. Dustin Neat will recover for third. Fourth, we'll go to the 49 of John Gill. And fifth, going to be the 7J of Jerry Rutherford. John Gill, third, the six of Dustin Neat. Second, the 5B of Mike Marler. And grabbing the win in Country 100.9 Mike FM Heat 3. And the Jason Smith-owned Barry Wright race car powered by Custom Race Engine, sponsored by Smith Forklift, King's Trucking, Lee's 4x4, and Indiana Southern Recycling out of Ashland, Kentucky. A big round of applause for the Kentucky Colonel, Steve Francis. And a third-place starter, Michael Chilton, has pulled to the infield. Problems on that machine. So only six of the eight scheduled to go now. As Green is out, and here we go. Webb and Lee side by side off two down the back straight away. Still side by side off of four. Lee will grab the lead. Webb will be second. Tommy Bailey third. Gary Christian going to be fourth. Then it'll be Todd Kaufman and Wesley Brummett. Lee, your leader, is Bailey trying to find some running room beneath the 13W of Webb for the runner-up slot off two down the back straight away. They'll go. Bailey out of Corbin, Webb out of Nicholasville, duking it out, door to door for second at this point. Webb will close the door on him off two, off four down the front straight away, but Bailey right back beneath him off of two. Tight quarter action, put Bailey into second. Move Webb back to third, and Bailey will set his sights on race leader Victor Lee and the number four. Webb trying to poke the nose back beneath Bailey off two, not able to make a move. He'll try it again into turn three off the bottom. They're still battling for the runner-up slot as we're halfway home in this one. Five down, five to go. Webb alongside of Bailey again. They are wheel-to-wheel for the runner-up spot into turn three. Still side by side. Close quarters off four. Webb by a car length for second at the line. All this going on behind race leader Victor Lee with six in the books. We'll put seven on the board this time off of four. Lee the leader, Webb second. Bailey third, Christian fourth, Kaufman sixth. The two to go signals out, two to go, and Country 100.9 Mike FM heat race number four. The white flag is out, one lap to settle the issue in this one, and it is all Victor Lee out in front at this point. Down the back straight away, they'll go for the final time into turn three off four. Danville, Kentucky's Victor Lee, the winner of Country 100.9 Mike FM heat race number four. David Webb will come home in second. Third will be Tommy Bailey. Fourth to Gary Christian. And fifth to Todd Kaufman. Top four transfer on. Fourth to 58 of Gary Christian. Third, the 11 of Tommy Bailey. Second to 13W of David Webb. And the winner of Country 100.9 Mike FM heat race number four. And the Kevin Eisen-owned Revolution race car. Modified heat one about to come to green. 10 laps, everybody will transfer. Mod heats two and three, stage them up. Denny and Hopper bringing them to green. Green's out, here we go. Three wide into turn one. Who's coming out of there with it? Matthew Hopper, the race leader. Tommy Bailey to the outside, looking to go to second. Brent Denny and Elliot Despain going at it for third and fourth. Sykun to fifth, then it's Matthew Colston, Scott Wells, and Mike Petrie. That's going to let the 20 of Tommy Bailey grab the race lead off of turn number four now. Bailey, your leader. Hopper second, Denny third, Despain fourth into 16E. And Sykun to his fifth into 44. Despain to the outside of Denny, off two down the back straight away. Looks like he's got the third spot into turn number three now. Despain finished fourth up at Twin Cities Raceway Park in North Vernon, Indiana last Saturday night. Close it in on the midpoint here, and it is all Tommy Bailey out in front. And we got a caution. The one of Scott Wells has looped that machine over in turn number three. Caution flag is out. Heat number one. Starts eighth with four to books, one lap shy of the midpoint. Single file nose to tail at the cone, and here we go. Gundiff trying to find a way around the 16 of Brent Denny down into turn three. That's a battle for the fourth spot. Well, Despain put some pressure on Hopper for second off fourth, and the 114 of Mike Petrie spins in the center of turn three and four. Caution flag is out, and Scott Wells' machine also stopped up there as well. $50-50 tickets, a buck a piece, six for $5. That young lady will be going to count her money at the conclusion of the Super Late Model B mains. Coming up here in just a bit. Bailey's set to bring them back to green at the cone, and here we go. Despain looking to the inside of Hopper for the second spot into turn number three. We'll put lap six up on the Pepsi scoreboard right here. Six down, four to go. Tommy Bailey, class of the field so far in this heat. Elliott Despain with the slider on Matthew Hopper. He'll go to the runner-up spot off two down the back chute. Bailey the leader, Despain now second. Hopper rides in third. Denny fourth, Cundiff fifth, Colston sixth, and Petrie seventh. The two to go signal out on this one. Eight down, two to go in Intercounty Energy Modified Heat Race number one for the Bluegrass Drugstore Modifieds. And a big ball of fire from an A-side Cundiff's number 44, and he goes to the infield. As the checkered flag is out, Tommy Bailey gonna be your winner. Elliott Despain comes home in second. Third will be Matthew Hopper in the 92. Fourth will be the 16 of Brett Denny. Fifth, the 57 of Matthew Colston. And Cy Cundiff quickly out of that race car, but it went up in a ball of fire there off of turn number four. This one will start outside the front row. And a pair of Somerset Pulaski County natives on the front row. This one, the 99 of Jerry Piles, the 27 of Gerald Haynes Jr. Modified Heat 3 needs to be in staging. Super Late Model B Main 1 needs to start staging behind it, please. Green flags out on this one. Good looking start, and here we go. Three wide, almost four wide into turn number one. Gerald Haynes Jr. comes out of there with the race lead. Jerry Piles, Cameron Marler, and Michael England battling for second, third, and fourth. Cameron Marler has second, but Michael England in that GRT with a Pro Power beneath the hood, looking to get that runner-up spot. Cars together, England and Haynes made contact. But we got caution. Caution is out for the 24 of Glenn Hounshell Jr. So we'll go back to the last completed laps. Gerald Haynes Jr. set to bring the field back to green. At the cone, off turn four, eyes on him, and here we go. Marler looks to the inside of Haynes for the lead, off two down the back straight away. They'll battle into turn three, side by side for the top spot. Decker into the concrete up in turn up four, but continues on. But he may have damage on that machine. It appears he does on the right front. And we got caution. Caution is out as Robbie Settles loops the 58 in turn two. Green's back out, and here we go. Marler gonna look beneath Haynes again. They battle for the lead off two down the back chute. Three-way battle for the lead. Haynes has it, but Cameron Marler and Michael England battling him for it. As they work off two down the back straight away, Haynes will hang on to the lead for the time being as we're going to be one lap shy of the midpoint right here. Four down, six to go in Intercounty Energy heat number two. The halfway signal's down. Five down, five to go. Six in the books, field working lap number seven. Gerald Haynes Jr. showing the way. Cameron Marler and Michael England, though, trying to find a way around him. As we've got seven down, three remain. England now trying to look beneath Cameron Marler for the runner-up slot as the two to go signal has been shown. Eight down, two to go. Gerald Haynes Jr. showing the way. White flag about to be displayed. One to go here in this one. Gerald Haynes Jr. looking to get his first win at a modified here in Intercounty Energy Heat number two. And off of turn number four, Somerset's Gerald Haynes Jr. will win Intercounty Energy Heat number two. Second will be Cameron Marler. Third will go to Michael England. Fourth, the 99 of Jerry Piles. Fifth, got to go to the five of Stacy Decker and six to the 58 of Robbie Settles. Top three finishers out of this. Super late model B main one and two to staging, please. Super late model B main one and two to staging, please. Greens out on heat number three, and we are rocking and rolling off turn number two. Matthew Jordan going to jump to the top spot. Deion Benningfield second, but here comes the 0-3 of Benji Lee looking to the outside, not able to make a move, along with the 28 of JT Ayers. You got a lightning out front and a quartet of bandits running second, third, fourth, and fifth. Make it five of them as Aaron Cox, sixth and a bandit as well. Bailey a little out of shape off three. That's let the 75 of Deion Benningfield into JT Ayers working beneath Lee. And we got a dandy of a race going on here in Intercounty Energy Modified heat number three. Jordan the leader, Benningfield second by a half car length. Ayers is third, Lee fourth, Wilson fifth. Ayers to the inside of Benningfield now for the runner-up position into turn three. Jordan checked a bit, that let the second and third place cars close on him a bit. But Jordan hangs on to the lead, one lap shy of the midpoint as we get ready to see the halfway signal in Intercounty Energy qualifying heat three for the Bluegrass Drugstore Modified. Five down, five to go. Jordan the leader. Here comes Kid Smooth. JT Ayers trying to poke a nose beneath him for the lead down into turn number three. While Cousins, Benji Lee, and Deion Benningfield battle for third and fourth. Lee with the slider on Benningfield, but Benningfield looks right back beneath him for third down into turn number one. This one's been a dandy. There'll be seven laps scored this time by. Seven down, three to go. Matthew Jordan looking to get his first modified checkered flag here at Ponderosa Speedway this season in Intercounty Energy Heat 3. And the 0-3 of Benji Lee starting to flex his muscle now a bit. Oh, he'll fire the slider and go from third to first off four. But here comes Matthew Jordan right back beneath him for the lead with two to go. Lee taking the long way around up on the top shelf off two. Put Benji Lee to the point, but here comes Jordan right back beneath him in the center of turn three and four. Now Ayers looks beneath Jordan. He'll take second with the white flag waving. Lee with it in hand at this point. Ayers second. Benningfield going to get around Jordan. Off of turn four. Intercounty Energy Heat 3 will go to Benji Lee. Second will go to JT Ayers. Third, Matthew Jordan. as Deion Benningfield sits pointed in the wrong direction. Rocky Wilson fourth. Aaron Cox fifth. And track officials saying the 17J of Matthew Jordan getting into the 75 of Benningfield. So Deion Benningfield is going to be credited with third in the finish. Derek Fisher into 38 and the 25 of Dennis Roberson, set to bring him to green. 10 laps, top three, going on to the show. Everyone else will go to the trailer, be done for the night. Greentown, here we go. Derek Fisher jumps out to the race lead in the Mike Sports Zone, number 38. Tim Tungett jumps into the runner-up slot. Dennis Roberson third, Jeff Rollins fourth. Dan Sleeper sets in fifth. Jake Henry, sixth. Billy Merritt to seventh. Tommy Carlton is eighth. Again, the top three will race their way into the show. You've got two laps forward right here. Keep your eye on the 75 of Dan Sleeper trying to make the basement, the bottom side of the race surface work. As he's rolled his way up to fourth and sets his sights on third place, running Dennis Roberson in the 25. The one of Tommy Carlton rolls his machine pit side. Meanwhile, Derek Fisher continues to show the way. Tim Tungett is second. As Dan Sleeper puts the pressure on Dennis Roberson, that's for the third and final transfer spot off two. As we get ready to come to the halfway signal, five down, five to go in Airport Road Salvage Yard, B Main number one. Derek Fisher with this one well in hand at this point. Tim Tungett in second. Battle's going to be for the third and final transfer spot, the 25 of Roberson, the 75 of Sleeper. Roberson with a comfortable lead over Tungett in the Bob and Robbie Bennett on the Rocket chassis tonight. The Rocket of Roberson in third, the Rayburn of Sleeper riding in fourth, the first man on the outside looking in right now. As a two lap to go signal's been shown, two to go here in this one. Yeah, Derek Fisher working off the bottom side of four, gonna see the white flag, one to go in Airport Road Salvage Yard, B-May number one. The top three are gonna transfer. Your winner working off of turn number four, Olympia, Kentucky's Derek Fisher, the winner of Airport Road Salvage Yard, B-May number one. Second will go to the 14B of Tim Tungett. Third, the 25 of Dennis Roberson. Fourth will be the 15 of Jeff Rawlings. And fifth, the 25 of Billy Meredith. As Dan Sleeper spinning on the last lap there. Rutherford and Kaufman set to bring them to green. Top three transfer, Green's out, here we go. Rutherford and Kaufman side by side for the lead. Three wide for third into turn three there. Chilton, Grummet, and Belcher, and Chilton gonna grab the third spot. Rutherford showing the way. Kaufman getting some heat from Chilton now for second down into turn three. Chilton with problems, didn't start his heat, having to start out back in this one. But it looks like he's got a fast hot rod here as he has rolled to second and sets his sights on race leader Jerry Rutherford. 10 laps of distance, the top three will transfer. And Chilton with a half car length advantage has the lead on lap number three over Rutherford now, working lap number four. Chilton out in front. Chilton and Steve Caden on the Revolution race car. Kaufman trying to get around Rutherford for the second spot. He had it at the line. As Timmy Taylor pulls the five machine in, his night is finished. Shelton continuing to show the way. We will have seven laps scored this time. We'll have two laps remaining this time. Chilton out for a Friday night stroll right now in this one. As the two lap to go signal goes out, Chilton showing away. Kaufman second, Rutherford is third. Then it's Belcher and Brummett. White flag in the air, one lap to settle the issue here in Airport Road Salvage Yard, B main number two. Checkered flag down, South Bison, Kentucky's Michael Chilton, the winner, second. We'll go to Todd Kaufman, third to Jerry Rutherford. Fourth and fifth will go to Clarence Belcher and Wesley Brummett. Cheeks and Branham set to bring them to green. Eyes on them. Green's out for eight laps, and here we go. In between cars, Glenn Branham and Logan White is going to be battling for the lead. Glenn Branham showing the way into zero. Logan White is second. Terry Cheeks, Tony Rowland, and Pat Hagen from the rear of the field up to third. Yes, Cheeks will slide up in front of Hagen for third, but Hagen going to get it back down into turn number three. Cheeks fourth, Tony Rowland fifth. Rowland a regular at Florence Speedway up in Union, Kentucky. Phillip Anderson sixth. Branham clips the concrete off four, but continues to hang on to the race lead. We're halfway home in this one. Four down, four to go. Sportsman Heat 2, the final preliminary event of the night. Coming up next, get a name a 50-50 ticket lady in the office counting her money as we got a battle for the lead. And I put Logan White is to the point now in the 33. Two laps remaining in this one. Logan White is showing away in the 33. As the white flag about to be displayed, one lap to go here in Northside RV Heat Race number one for the Dandy Powder Recycler Sportsman. Off of turn number four, checkered flags out for Houston Mills. Logan White is the winner of Northside RV Heat one. Glenn Branham will go second. Pat Hagen is third. Tony Rowland comes home fourth. Eyes on them as we get set to come to green. Green is out, here we go. Glenn Hounshell Jr., Gary Thompson battling for the lead. Donnie Sullivan third, Derek Bottoms fourth. Jeff Johnson fifth, and it's Johnny King and Eddie Stewart. Glenn Hauschild Jr. continuing to show the way. Gary Thompson is second, but Donnie Sullivan pressuring him for the runner-up slot now. Derek Bottoms third. Jeff Johnson fourth. Then it's Johnny King and Phillip Anderson. This will be one lap shy of the midpoint right here. Three down, five to go. Johnson out of shape, gathers it back up. He'll lose the spot to Johnny Kingo. The halfway signal out on this one, four down, four to go. Glenn Hauschild Jr., multi-time feature winner here this season, showing the way. Donnie Sullivan is second. As Derek Bottoms and Gary Thompson side by side for the third spot here, all four coming at you down the front straightaway. With five in the books, three remain. Two laps remaining this time for race leader Glenn Hauschild Jr. in the number 20. And a white flag about to be displayed. One lap to settle the issue in Northside RV race number 2. Hauschild the leader, Sullivan second. As Derek Bottoms and Gary Thompson race hard for that third spot. And off of turn four, Northside RV Heat Race 2 will go to Mount Vernon's Glenn Hauschild Jr. Second will be the one of Donnie Sullivan. Third, the T3 of Gary Thompson. Fourth to the 93 of Derek Bottoms. Fifth to the 07 of Jeff Johnson. And your Noah took the animals on the arc, and we are coming to green next time. Bye. And all Grayson, Kentucky, front row, Jackie Boggs into 4B, Josh McGuire into 41. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime! We've got 10 laps in, and we've got a battle for the lead down the back straightaway in traffic. Mike Marler, who started toward the middle of the pack, trying to work his way past Jackie Boggs, and he's got it done on lap 11. The 2010 Friday Night Rumble winner, Mike Marler, out in front. In the 5B, smoke from Victor Lee's number four. As Victor Lee's number four is up in smoke. Wow, they're racing all over the place out there, race fans. Mike Marler in charge of the restart at the restart cone, sitting there in turn number four. Eyes on him, and here we go. Jackie Boggs went back around Mike Marler on the restart, took the lead back on lap 12. He's your race leader. Marler second, Neat third. 17th starter Derek Fisher has made his way to fourth. Steve Francis fifth, Brad Neat up to sixth now. Neat started in the fifth spot. Dustin Limble seventh, Dennis Earp Jr. eighth, Greg Johnson, who started 15th, is up to ninth. Josh McGuire, the final car in the top 10 at this point. We'll have 18 laps complete right here for race leader Jackie Boggs. Definitely a top and bottom out there so far in this one. The leaders working the top shift through three and four, while they dive to the basement down in turn one and two, and Boggs is going to have to start the process of lapping slower traffic again here momentarily. Rutherford, Mike Marler will do the same down into turn three. Boggs sets his sights now. The next car, he'll have to put a lap down, the 14 of Tim Tungit. And Boggs has got that done into turn number three. Marler looking to the bottom of Boggs off of four. Not able to make the move. And Dustin Neat third. Brad Neat now sets into fifth spot. Steve Francis sixth. Dustin Limble. Josh McGuire is now ninth. Greg Johnson tenth. We'll do the same down into turn three. Boggs sets his sights now. The next car, he'll have to put a lap down, the 14 of Tim Tungit. And Boggs has got that done into turn number three. Marler looking to the bottom of Boggs off of four. Not able to make the move. And Dustin Neat third. Derek Fisher is fourth. Brad Neat now sets into fifth spot. Steve Francis sixth, Dustin Limble seventh, Dennis Earp Jr. eighth, Josh McGuire is now ninth, Greg Johnson tenth. And Greg Johnson has contacted the concrete in turn four and climbed up on it. And the caution flag is out. Jackie Boggs out in front looking for his first ever win at Ponderosa Speedway. We'll bring him back to green. Eyes on him at the cone with 22 in the books. Here we go. And caution is out. Jeff Watson with a flat left rear on the 11. 24 laps are official. Green's back out. Here we go. And I don't believe that's going to go. Later's out front by himself. Eyes on him at the cone. Here we go. And Dustin Neat trying to work beneath Jackie Boggs for the lead. He'll slide up in front of him off of turn number four. We got a new leader, Dustin Neat. Dustin Neat shows the way. Now Mike Marler looking beneath Jackie Boggs. They are side by side for second into turn three. Brad Neat is fourth. Dustin Neat the leader. Jackie Boggs second. Mike Marler third. Brad Neat fourth. Steve Francis fifth. Derek Fisher sixth. Dustin Linville seventh. Michael Chilton, who started in 18th, sits in eighth. Josh McGuire is ninth. Boggs got awful close to the concrete up in turn number two, and he slows going out of back straight away, and we're going to have caution. Caution is out. Dustin Neat in charge of the restart here at the cone with 27 laps scored, 33 remain. Eyes on him. Here we go. Eyes on him at the cone here off of turn four, and here we go. And caution flag waves once again to 13W of David Webb. And we'll try it again. Hopefully we get some green flag laps in right here. Green's back out, and here we go. And a halfway signal goes out, 30 down, 30 to go. Dustin Neat the race leader, Mike Marler second, Brad Neat is third, Steve Francis fourth, Dustin Linville fifth, Dennis Erb sixth, Justin Ratliff's making the top side work. He and Chris Combs battling for seventh and eighth. Michael Chilton ninth. Jeff Watson has worked his way back up to 10. They are three wide for the sixth position down the back straightaway and into turn number three. Dennis Earp Jr., the meeting the sandwich between Chris Combs and Justin Ratliff. Justin Neat continuing to show the way. Mike Marler still second. Brad Neat third. Steve Francis fourth. Dustin Linville rides in fifth. Justin Ratliff and Chris Combs now side by side for sixth and seventh. Michael Chilton eighth. Dennis Earp Jr. ninth. Jeff Watson, the final car in the top 10. David Webb slows the 13 here on the front straightaway, and his night looks to be finished with 36 laps scored. Justin Neat out in front continues to lead the way. Mike Marler second. Brad Neat is third. Steve Francis fourth. Dustin Linville fifth. Ratliff and Combs continue to battle for sixth and seventh. Chilton eighth. Herb ninth. Jeff Watson tenth. The lead trio down the back straightaway as they start to ride in that part that's blacked up and cleaned off up on the top side of the racing surface. But they dive to the basement down to the bottom of turns one and two. And if we stay green, race leader Dustin Neat going to encounter some slower traffic here in just a few laps as we've got 20 to go, 40 down, 20 to go. Dustin Neat going to try to start the process of working traffic here. With 42 laps scored. Neat with about a third of a straightaway back to second place running Mike Marler. Brad Neat is third. Dustin Linville looking at Steve Francis. That's for the fourth spot at the line. Too close to call. Chris Combs is sixth, Justin Ratliff seventh, Michael Chilton eighth, Dennis Earp Jr. ninth, Jeff Watson the final car in the top 10 as we've got 16 to go. Dustin Neat trying to work beneath the 14 of Tim Tungit and put him a lap down, and he'll have that done off turn number four with a 14 laps to go. The next car in Neat's sights is going to be the 15 of Greg Johnson as he will attempt to put him a lap down. Mike Marler still second, Brad Neat third, Dustin Linville fourth, Steve Francis fifth, Chris Combs sixth. Ratliff seventh, Chilton eighth, Herb ninth, Watson tenth. As Dennis Roberson's number 25 slows to the bottom of turn one and two, and Roberson goes pit side. And Dustin Neat clear of Greg Johnson now with 11 to go. Oh, and leader Dustin Neat. And it appeared to 38 of Derek Fisher may have been slowing to come to the end. Mike Marler with the field in tow will bring him to green. Eyes on him. Green's back out, and here we go. Marler with the lead. Limbel trying to grab second from Needoff. Four down the front straight away. Too close to call for second at the line. They were almost three wide for fourth there momentarily. Radliff to the outside of Francis down the back straight away, trying to grab the fourth position away from the Kentucky Colonel. Down the front, shoot now, put the Rattler to fourth with less than 10 to go. Marler shows the way out in front. There'll be nine laps remaining. Brad Need second, Dustin Linville third, Justin Ratliff fourth, Steve Francis fifth, Chris Combs sixth, Michael Chilton seventh, Josh McGuire eighth, Jeff Watson ninth, Todd Kaufman is 10th with 52 down. Combs trying to work beneath. Chilton slows over on the back straight away now into turn number three, and that's going to draw caution. Caution is out again. Flat right rear tire on Michael Chilton's 97 machine, the culprit for this caution. Caution lights are out, and we are coming back to green with eight to go. Eyes on them at the cone. Green's back out. Here we go. Marler showing the way. Brad Need second. Dustin Linville third. Justin Ratliff trying to make the top shelf work through one and two. Rides fourth. Steve Francis fifth. As we've got six to go this time. Five laps remaining. Mike Marler continues to show the way. Brad Need riding in second. Dustin Limble holding down the third spot. As we'll have four to go right here. Mike Marler trying to become the second two-time winner of the Friday Night Rumble. Jason Keltner won it in 08 and 09. Marler won it in 10. Or excuse me, Jason Keltner winning it in 07 and 08. Marler won it in 10, trying to become the second two-time winner with three to go. And the field about to get the two lap to go signal right here. Two remaining in the Friday Night Rumble presented by Need Service Center. Mike Marler showing the way. He'll come off turn number four to the white flag. One lap to go. One lap to settle the issue here in this one. Down the back straight away. They'll go for the final time. Mike Marler showing the way into turn three. Off of turn four, the Friday Night Rumble presented by Need Service Center. We're going to the Winfield Warrior, Mike Marler. Brad Need comes on second. Dustin Limble will finish third. Justin Ratliff fourth. Prince Combs for a slight job on Steve Francis will finish in fifth. Hopefully the third time will be the charm. We come to green here off turn four. Green's out. Here we go.
Washington flag waves. Matthew Coast in the 57, the 24, Glenn Hounshell Jr. Contact down in turn one and two.
Tommy Bailey with the field in tow, set to bring him back to green off turn four. Eyes on him. Green's back out, and here we go. Bailey lead him down the back straightaway. Lee second, just playing third. They were three wide for fourth there momentarily. Marler, Haynes, and Ayers. And it looks like Ayers going to come out of there with the fourth spot. And Bailey slips to one and two. That's let the 03 MNG Lee grab the race lead with a four laps now scored. The 16E of Despain, third. Single file, nose to tail, eyes on them at the cone. Here we go. Bailey 1-2, Ayers and Lee side by side for third and fourth. Marler fifth, put the 28 of Ayers to third. Despain back to fourth. Marler now fifth. Five laps in. We'll have six in this time. Goldston took a detour through the infield there, but continues on. In 15 laps of scheduled distance now, and we'll get the halfway signal on this one. Benji Lee, the race leader. Tommy Bailey, second. J.T. Ayers rides in third. Elliott Despain, fourth. Gerald Haynes, Jr., and Cameron Marler battling for fifth and sixth. Michael England, seventh. Matthew Hopper, eighth. Brent Denny, ninth. Deion Benningfield, the final car in the top 10. Now Wells, he'll call it a night, pull his machine to the infield. And we'll have Hopper, eighth. Brent Denny, ninth. Deion Benningfield, the final car in the top 10. The one car, Scott Wells, he'll call it a night, pull his machine to the infield. Five to go with fifth and sixth. Michael England, seventh. Matthew Hopper, eight. Brent Denny, ninth. Deion Benningfield, the final car in the top 10. The one car, Scott Wells, he'll call it a night, pull his machine to the infield. And we'll have five to go this time by, five laps remaining. And Benji Lee starting to extend his lead now over second place car, Tommy Bailey. Working traffic here off turn number four with four laps to go. Sportsman feature, you should be staged, you're next. Sportsman feature, you're staging, you're next. Three laps remaining. They'll fire at the cone off turn number four, and here we go. Lee with Bailey hot on his heels into turn three and four. They're going to get the two lap to go signal right here. Two to go. the leader of Bailey. Second, Ayers. Third, to Spain. Fourth, Gerald Haynes Jr. in a fifth as the white flag will wave. One lap to settle the issue here in this one. And off of turn number four, Benji Lee will grab the win in tonight's Bluegrass Drugstore Modified feature. Tommy Bailey second, JT Ayers third. Elliott Despain comes home in fourth with Gerald Haynes Jr., the final car in the top five. Your top five finishers, fifth the 27 of Gerald Haynes Jr., fourth the 16 E of Elliott Despain, third the 28 of JT Ayers, second the 20 machine of Tommy Bailey, and grabbing the win after taking the lead on lap number four in the Brittany Lee-owned Bandit race car with the Dale Mears engine, sponsored by Thomas & Son Trucking, On-Time Courier, On-Time Construction, Springfield Napa, Terry Mills State Representative, Smart Shoppers, Thompson Heat and Air, and St. Joe Garage, the current division points leader in the 0-3 out of Loretto, Kentucky. Big round of applause for Benji Lee. Out, we're going to come to green. Logan White is in the 33. Glenn House Jr. in the 20. Set to bring him to green. Green flag is out, and here we go. Glenn Houshel Jr. going to jump to the race lead. Logan White is second. Donnie Sullivan sits third. Gary Thompson fourth. Glenn Branham in the zero and the 88 of Pat Hagen going at it for fifth and sixth. Derek Bottom seventh. Jeff Johnson eighth. And Glenn Branham Jr. spinning the zero. Caution lights are out. Glenn Houshel Jr. will bring them back to green. Looking to make it two in a row. Green's back out, and here we go. We've got the Sportsman win here back on August the 3rd. Donnie Sullivan looking to get beneath Logan White. That's a battle for second. Put Sullivan to second off of turn number four. Problems on Logan White. This is 33. He's got a flat right front tire, and he's headed to the hot pit to try to get that changed. And we are coming to green. Glenn Houshel Jr. wants to get in charge of the restart. Green's back at it. Here we go. Glenn Houshel Jr. showing away. Donnie Sullivan challenging him for the second position. Gary Thompson third. Pat Hagen fourth. Gary Bottoms is fifth. And Thompson inches in on Sullivan's back bumper as they go into turn number three. Jerry Cheek spinning the 24 over in turn. No. Told this one's going to be trimmed to 12 laps. 12 laps now. I eyes on them at the cold off of turn number four. Green's back out. Here we go. We'll get the halfway signal. Six down, six to go. And the leader spins down in turn number one. Six official, six remain. Glenn Hounsell Jr. will bring them back to green. Eyes on them here off turn number four. Green's back out, and here we go. Showing away four-way battle for second, third, fourth, and fifth. You can throw Grandma's blanket over them there in the center of turn one and two. And they're going to get three wide for second now. Contact between a couple of cars. Everyone through cleanly and safely. Derek Bottoms is going to go to the second spot. Pat Hagen back to third. Gary Thompson fourth, Logan White is from the rear of the field. He's back up to fifth. Yeah, we'll get the two to go signal right here on this one. Two lap to go signal is out. Glenn Hounsell Jr. with a comfortable lead at this point. Sees the white flag, one lap to settle the issue. Here in tonight's D&D Panel Recycler Sportsman main event. And off of turn number four, Mount Vernon's Glenn Hounsell Jr. will grab the win. Second, oh, we got a car upside down. Jeff Johnson flips. Derek Bottoms will take second. Pat Hagen's going to be third. Logan White is fourth. And Johnny King will come home fifth. Third, the 88 of Pat Hagen, second, the 93 of Derek Bottoms, and grabbing the Sportsman Feature Event win. In his own Super Sport Camaro, sponsored by Wayne Bowen, R&R Builders, Madison Windows, Atlanta Scrap and Metal, Jennings Do It Best Home Center, VC Verlin's Contracting, Central Kentucky Sheet Metal, Pico, and Jay's Golf Carts out of Mount Vernon, Kentucky. Big round of applause for Glenn Hounsell Jr. And race fans, as you make your way toward the exits, we thank you for joining us this evening for the Friday Night Rumble presented by Neat Service Center. Enjoy your Labor Day weekend and World 100 weekend. We'll see you back here on Fan Appreciation Night, Friday, September the 13th.